Yo, you got the juice now, man.
He comes to us live from Atlantic City, New Jersey. Please welcome Anthony Juice.
Calling y'all with 2 weeks' notice. Give me a month, I'll fight whoever. I'm always in shape.
We are checking in here in Egg Harbor, New Jersey, with trainer Ray McCline. To your left on the screen and to the right is Anthony Juice Young, 6-0 with 2 knockouts. Young welterweight coming up quickly in the game. First and foremost, want to thank you both for inviting us into your house here today for training. But Ray, if you could touch a little bit on, you know, how everything's been going with Juice. Now he's been moving almost a full year now as a professional fighter, and how you feel everything's progressing.
Everything's progressing pretty well, pretty much on schedule. With what we started out, what the plan was starting out, and we're, you know, halfway to our mark. We have a couple more months left in this year. We are still hoping to get 4 fights, if not, you know, at least 2. Plan was to be a 10-0 or 8-0 by the end of the year, and we're, you know, pretty much set for that. And we would have probably superseded that if Juice didn't have an injury a few months back with his shoulder that kept him out. But we're pretty excited, you know, about what we are right now and what we're going, what the future holds for us.
And Juice, how about yourself? How do you feel? You know, everything's kind of gone here in the you know, your first little bit less than a year as a professional fighter. You know, how do you feel like you kind of fallen into your groove and, you know, feeling like, how do you feel overall?
I feel good overall. Honestly, though, as a fighter, I don't think I hit my groove yet. That's going to be a scary thing when I hit my groove. I feel like I'm just performing good enough to win right now. I haven't really hit my groove yet. It got in my bag, as they were, as we like to say around here. But when I hop in either my Louis or Gucci bag, they're going to see.
No question. The Juice is obviously, anybody watching this video is going to see, you definitely have a good time here. It is work. You're putting in good work, but you're also enjoying yourself. You think that's some of the key reasons you're able to progress along as, you know, as you are? Because you actually do enjoy being here in the gym?
Yeah, you got to enjoy being here. You don't want to come in here and it's like, oh, I got to go to the gym. When I come to the gym, I turn my music on. I enjoy myself. I like to dance, have fun. A lot of times my friends are in here with me. I play around with my trainers. You know, I just like to have a good time. I'm a good, a fun person all around.
And Ray, how is it to, you know, to have a fighter like Juice that's in here obviously enjoying himself, and, you know, he knows when it's time to work, but he knows also how to enjoy himself?
He's a rare athlete. I mean, there's some guys that you can look at and you recognize the talent level that they have, you know. You understand the personality that they have and the flamboyance in which, you know, Juice, you know, has. I mean, there's not too many people can have the name that he has, Juice, and not, you know, have the energy to go along with it. I mean, so he, you know, his name fits him, you know, perfect. I mean, and he's it's fun. I mean, it's a lot, you know, to be able to, you know, have to. It's a lot to be able to harness that type of talent and know how to max, you know, get the max out of it. But at the same time, allow him to be who he is, and you know, without you know trying to you know distinguish, you know, that fire that's in him. And I mean, and he balances it out pretty good.
Absolutely. And now, Ray, you spoke a little bit about, you know, kind of the plans for the rest of the year, you know, as far as bouts and everything. But even into 2013 a little bit, could you give us a little insight on, you know, kind of where you see things headed and, you know, where you kind of hope to be here, you know, in the next maybe 6 months to a year?
Hey, well, Rich Mancini, Juice's manager, has been doing an excellent job, you know, and moving his career. When we came together, I think it was in October, you know, we set out, you know, to follow a game plan that we have for the, this year, you know, going into 2013. And we're, like I said, we're on the mark of where we want to be at. And the future for Juice, you know, is I think is, you know, to be able to match where we are this year, you know, 6 to 10 fights. Also, we expect Juice to be fighting, you know, in a co-feature. Or main event locally, you know, here in the Atlantic City area, as well as, you know, on a national level. We expect to, you know, be on ESPN. We expect to be on Showbox. We expect to be on fighting Boxing After Dark. I mean, there's a lot of goals that we have that we think we're going to, you know, reach next year. And, you know, we expect to, you know, be there. You know, by the end of, by this time next year, we expect to be have our name, you know, on that list of, you know, top prospects, you know, in the nation.
Absolutely. And Juice, you know, kind of speaking on what Ray was, you know, brought up there, last fight out was you were the swing bout for, you know, ESPN Friday Night Fights. You know, unfortunately, both the fights went the distance, which meant that you weren't able to get on TV, but you're right there on the verge of doing that. And, you know, to know that spotlight's so close and, you know, you're turning a lot of heads in the game, and a lot of people have their eyes on you now. You know, what are some of the things that you're going to do to make sure you're getting better every day and to remain humble and, you know, continue pursuing the path that you've chosen?
Just staying hungry. That's all. I'm starving right now. I was upset that I didn't get on TV, but at the same time, I was kind of happy because I didn't perform the way I wanted to perform, and I didn't want people to get a taste like, that's the boy that they talking about. So it wasn't on TV, so they didn't really get to see it. So, but I'm just staying hungry and positive. You surround myself with good people, got a good team. My family keeps me grounded, my little brothers and sisters, as y'all know who they are. But yeah, other than that, that's what keeps me hungry and motivated.
Absolutely. And to kind of take us home, kind of let you both grab the microphone for a second. We'll start with you though, Ray. You know, what are some of the things that when somebody leaves a fight with Juice, or even watching this video and seeing how he's trained, what are some of the things you hope they take away from Juice?
Well, I think, you know, it stands out that when you meet him, you recognize his personality, you know, right away. And when you see him perform, even when he thinks he doesn't perform well, you still walk away seeing his talent, you know, and you see his skill set. And the things that he's able to do from day one to where he is now, I mean, again, he's only been a professional a little over 8 months, you know, 9 months right now. And he's at 6 pro fights, going on to a 7 pro fight. I mean, he's been in with some pretty good, you know, caliber fighters. We've made sure that we've matched him, you know, well. You know, we haven't given him any, lay down fights. I mean, he's been in with some pretty good, talented guys, and he's had to perform. I mean, and those things are pushing him, you know, to come out, you know, what's inside of him. And we expect him to, you know, be at that top level in a couple years, and we're working to get to that, you know, get to that point. You see that he puts the work into the gym. When he's not in the gym, he's, you know, doing the right thing. He doesn't smoke, he doesn't drink, you know, he's not a street guy. You know, he makes sure that, you know, he does all the right things outside of the gym also. So, I mean, it makes the job a little easier. And it's, like I said, again, it's the hard part is to make sure that you keep all of that talent, you know, here and not, you know, let it just burst out too fast. And that's what we're trying to do. So, you know, when his career is supposed to peak, he's going to peak at the right place in the right time.
Absolutely. And Juice, why don't you go ahead and take us home? I don't know if you're the kind of person that likes to shout people out or, you know, let people know how they can get at you on Twitter, Instagram, anything like that. But I figure I'd give you a little bit of time in case you are.
Oh, yeah. I'd like to give a shout out to my man BJ, my high school football coach, for supplying me with the gear, Pure Blend. If you don't get with the movement, you better get with it, because when he blow up, you ain't got no clues, you're going to be left out. And I mean, you can follow me on Twitter at @ajuiceyoung and on Instagram at @juice_money. I'd like to give a shout out to the whole Juice crew, Resolution Sports, Coach Rick, my manager, Rich Messini, my pad man, Vincent Jackson, in Atlantic City and Pleasantville. We in here.
And one, just if you had to close it off on just two statements, Juice, for those people that might not have seen you yet, next time they see you, what are they going to see?
Two statements?
You can go three. You can do what you do.
Juice experience. When they see me fight, whether it be my ring walk, the knockout, or how I perform, they're going to be like, yo, I want to watch him fight next time. I don't know if it's going to be on TV. If it ain't on TV, I'm coming to see him. If I live in New York, I'm driving the 2 hours to come see him. They're going to want to see me again.
No question about it. Ray, Juice, definitely want to thank you both for inviting us in today. Juice, I see you got something for me.
Peace. Thanks, Resolution Sports.
Thank you both.
It's my mean grill.
I thought you smelled something.
That's my mean grill. Now I ain't gonna give y'all a born dead training. I'm real animated in the gym.
Why is that, Juice?
Well, that's just me. I like to have a good time. I'd rather it be in the, when I'm fighting, training. Can't come in here and just be an angry fart.
How you deal with this man like that, Ray?
I don't. Normally, my thing is to keep these two from arguing with one another. You know what I mean? Get into their little thing. If he say something to him, he'll say something back, and before you know it, it's a full-blown, you know, bus contest.
Tony Montana, riding with the hammer.
What you know about it, Juice?